Welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live. We're now joined by Vic Reeves and Bob Mortimer. Second series of Vic and Bob's Big Night Out. Second series of the new incarnation of it. Reincarnation.
Reincarnation. It's not really, it's nothing to do with the original Big Night Out. It's just got the same name.
It's a similar format.
It's the same.
It's not.
But it's a new version of it.
It's a new version of it.
It's new. It's up to date. You know, getting with it in the future.
George Clooney's on the first episode, isn't
he? Yeah, and he was looking gorgeous.
He was. Yeah. For anyone who's never seen it, I mean, how would you describe it?
It's a high-powered, steam-driven traction engine, a jet-powered traction engine. With lots of different things that happen. So it happens in half an hour, actually in real time, because we did it like we used to do the original Big Night Out.
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
We did it in front of an audience and we filmed it all in about 40 minutes. So you get that live feel.
Get that energy.
So the first series, it changed from that, did it? The first series of the new version of
No, that was the same.
You did it the same?
Yeah. So it's good discipline because, you know, there's no auto-cues, there's no retakes, just 3, 2, 1, go for it. And then 38 minutes later...
I said to you both, I watched the first episode of this week, and in the first 5 minutes, I genuinely think I laughed more at your first 5 minutes of it than pretty much everything else.
The rest was rubbish. The last five.
I was amazing. Then it turned off.
Than anything else I've seen this year.
But they say you've got to have a hot five in any comedy show, and that's OK. In comedy shows nowadays, you don't feel that they're feeling obliged to make you laugh all the time.
Yeah.
So, and I think maybe it's a curse, but we are trying to do that.
Is it good? It's 30 years ago, the first one.
Yeah.
Came out. It must be amazing that you're still doing the same stuff.
Well, rehashing the same
if you wait 30 years, you know.
Well, I think we've been on for 30 years. Every year we've had a TV show on. For 30 years, which I think makes us the longest running double act ever.
What he's saying is he'd like a silver cup.
I think we should be in the Guinness Book of Records.
The other thing you two are doing at the moment, you're quite active, both of you, on social media. We were saying before the show, you're
winning it.
Yeah, your social medias are absolutely brilliant. Is that something you're consciously sort of thinking it's something you want to get involved into? How does it happen?
Guys, I often think, I wonder why I do it. Do you sometimes think?
I just think, if you've got a good idea, sometimes good ideas can pass you by. So if you do it, you can put it on social media and then forget about it.
But you're not worried, though, that you're kind of giving away your best bit sometimes?
Because it never happens if you don't. I did that one you were talking about earlier on, the one I was playing with my band rehearsal yesterday.
We've got that. We've got, go on, tell us about it and then we'll show it, because we're going
to
play that.
So, I was just playing the piano. I said to my daughter, Lizzie, I said, get your ukulele, let's play. And then I said to Nancy, get the kazoo. But I really injured my finger doing a run-up on the keys, on the piano. But you know, we made laugh the most. We just filmed it for fun. But what happened was when I did that, whoop, and Nancy... responded with a kazoo.
Bob, you've just moved on to Instagram as well, haven't you?
Yeah, that's a tricky one. Don't really understand it. There's no to and fro, is there? You don't like get involved with anyone else. You just put stuff up there.
But I think that's nicer because
maybe.
Twitter's gone a bit. Times can be pretty horrible.
I think Jim's right. It's just like you have an idea. It is quite nice that you can do it. I do quite a lot from when I'm on the train.
The train guy's great.
Cappuccino. I have a campuchuchu. You're an adult lion, Tim. Yeah, it is nice. It's Jim's right, yeah. It's just you've got to have an idea and then you've done it and you can forget it and move on with your life, you know.
Yeah, well, you've been recently assessing and scoring the dressing room snacks you've been doing your PR. Yeah.
I think people... I like doing those ones. I think people would be... surprised to see like how barren the catering is on things.
Well, I think it's going to be glamorous. Yeah.
You've got a little cup with some hard-boiled sweets in and three Oreos.
everyone.
Yeah, but in fairness, he's knocking up four or five dinners.
That's true. Yeah, that's true. You never go home hungry.